Hello and welcome, everybody. Randy Replay back at it again here. It's week number 10 of the NFL season. Today, your Minnesota Vikings sitting at 3-5 are going to go up against the Washington football team sitting at 4-4. A couple things to take away before we get you out to kick off. The injury report is stacked with two starters this week. Mr. Axberg, the quarterback, injured for 2 weeks with a shoulder tear, not placed on the IR. He will be out for a little bit, obviously. So, Kenny Erickson will take over with Taylor Pallead, the punter, as the backup. They tried to get a deal done with a free agent, Cody Kessler. Just not going to happen in time for the game. Matthew Arnsdorf, who is a starting cornerback for this defense, left the game with broken ribs. He is out for 4 weeks. So now we are down to one quarterback listed on the roster and three cornerbacks in big areas that this team has struggled with as far as turnovers go. On the other side of the ball, the Washington football team has a bit of linebacker, Perry Riley Jr., who is out for 2 weeks. Kendall Fuller has a foot fracture. And the luckiest thing I've ever seen, this could win us the game. DeSean Jackson with an upper arm fracture. He is out. He comes back next week. So we don't have to face the speedster, who is what I was worried about coming into this game. Nobody is on IR for them. So we're going to take a look at the depth chart, and we're going to get you out to the field. Are you ready? Kenny Erickson will get the start. He gets the nod, obviously. He's the last quarterback on the roster. The team is 0-4 with him as a starter. Taylor Pallead, of course, the punter backing him up. Worst comes to worst, where Kenny Erickson and Taylor Pallead go down, it would fall to Barrio Alvarez. And then Brandon Baker. Brandon Baker having better throwing ability of the two. Now, there we go. We will go up to the cornerback. I know because of my voice it sounds like I'm saying corner, but I'm really not. So the cornerbacks will be Zachary Anderson, Justin Vanderschoff, Robert Nichols, and Paul Fritchie coming over from free safety. The backup over there, as Matthew Arnsdorf is out. So, this secondary has suffered a big loss. He is a big contributor to this here cause in this day and age. We're going to take a look at something quick here. I want you to see this. Kenny Erickson as a starter. He has thrown for 1,576 yards, 9 touchdowns, 11 interceptions on the season. Not terrible. It could be worse. Longest pass of 70. He is 125 for 207. That is 60% completion percentage for those of you that don't know how to do math or didn't look over here. Averaging 7.6 yards per attempt and 262 a game. Obviously, the passer rating is not where we want to see it. It is 76.4 rushing. He has 11 carries for 87 yards. One fumble, one yard. Longest run was 18. I honestly have no idea where that came from. It was obviously one of his games, but yeah. So starting cornerback, we're going to take a look at Matthew Arnsdorf and what he has contributed to this team. We're going to take a look at total tackles, if I can find it. There it is. So 46 total tackles that is split between 27 solo and 19 assisted. One tackle for loss, zero sacks, zero interceptions. Although he does have 4 interception return yards, doesn't make any sense to me. Fix your stuff, EA. Anyway, so that is Matthew Arnsdorf. In a nutshell, just a big tackle contributor here on this team. I think he leads the whole entire team in tackles. We will take a look at that after the game. I've wasted too much time blabbing. Most of you guys have grown bored of old Randy Replay at this stage of the game, suffering through 10 weeks of pregame, halftime, and postgame with the old Randers. So we're going to get you out to FedEx Field, where the field, I've been told, is not the greatest. You know, that you see chunks flying up instead of little blades of grass like you like to see in some of these NFL stadiums. Upkeep is definitely not, appears to be on their mind. But good news for everybody, the Minnesota Vikings will be wearing their old jerseys today. If I can find them. There we go. The old whitey tighties, as we like to call them. Back when the jerseys were bigger, the pads were bigger, the players were meaner. This has been Randy Replay's pregame show. We call it Randy Replay's pregame show. We're going to get you out to kick off here. Washington football team and the Minnesota Vikings. Let's go.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. Today, we've got an exciting matchup on tap. It's the Redskins coming in at 4-4, going up against the Vikings, who come in at 3-5. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We are just inside the Beltway, about 10 miles east of the Capitol Dome, as we come to you from FedEx Field here in Landover. Today we hit week 10, and we've got a good one in store between the Minnesota Vikings and the Washington Redskins. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. Charles, we look at this Redskin team as they interplay here. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Vikings, they're hitting their stride of late. Winners of three of their last four.
And the offense last week, they had things humming. If you're a defensive player, you may get overshadowed a little bit, but you're really buoyed by what your offense is doing.
So out comes the Redskins offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by their quarterback in his fifth year from Michigan State. It's Kirk Cousins. Now they run with Sims, losing 4 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. So here's the Viking offense making their way out, and leading them, Charles, their quarterback, their field general. And the quarterback, he's got some big threats at wideout.
And they seem to get bigger all the time, don't they, Brandon? Every time I look out and watch a game, we're getting these bigger, more athletic, acrobatic receivers.
And here is the Redskin defense.
Trent Murphy's number one attribute is playing against the run, but he continues to work hard on his pass rush skills.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this one's incomplete. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. Again, they run with Sims. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. That'll go as a loss of 5.
He'll make the play.
Here we go. 3-19.
On third down, Cousins finding time. And that is incomplete.
Themselves gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
Taken in at the 22. An excellent return that time, 26 yards. And the Vikings, they'll be set up well.
You want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. On play action, they'll throw. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Their big tight end, his fourth touchdown on the year.
Yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, but they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
He's going to float this one deep right side. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's brought down.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
They'll look to throw again. And this is going to be incomplete. Charles, that's an important third down stop. You don't want to spot him two touchdowns here early.
And Randy replay here along with a live replay. Kenny Erickson having a great game so far. He saw Liu Wang break from the coverage. He had a couple of options off to that left side, but he went with Liu Wang, who was beating his man. And he just out of bounds. I thought I saw something else on the live action cam. Now, this is such a timing route. If he throws it a little bit sooner, this would be his second touchdown of the game. Let's take a look at what he had out to the right side of the field. Oh, he might have had Josh Gable with a late break off of his route. He's looking left the whole play. He sees him. And he throws it. If he would have held on to the ball for just a split second and could get it out before number 55 gets in there, I think he may have had Josh Gable. You got to go with your sure play here. And it was just a miscommunication. We're going to get you back out to the field, though, where Brandon Baker is set to go for his first field goal of the day. Let's go.
And this one is right through. And the lead moves to 10-0.
Starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now's a play calling.
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Miles Paul.
Got him down. But what did he get out of it?
He sold the sizzle. He just had no stake.
I mean, was it 1 yard?
Yeah, you plays like that, you at least expect a first down. They're just 1 yard. They'll lose it.
A play fake to Jones. Now Cousins. He's got time. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free. Play fake. Cousins. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. A gigantic sack on third and goal. A loss of 12. They've been moving the ball well offensively, really getting into a groove. Last play, pass completion. Now, finally, the defense gets there.
And you have to find a way to disrupt their rhythm. Do you do it with coverage, or do you do it with pressure? They elected to go with pressure, and it was the right call.
They're on third and 10. They'll set up a throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And they convert on third with a gain of 22.
Just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Call it a gain is 7. Should be a fairly easy one here. And his kick is good. And they will take the lead at 13-10.
Just follow me. We'll get there. Sometimes that will do more to elevate a team than anything else.
See if he has that confidence. Nowhere to escape. He'll look to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And to the 43.
All right, here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
Now a second down throw for Cousins. Caught left side, Garcon. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. They'll throw now on the final play. He sets to fire deep. He's got it. Hit the 15. So we've reached halftime here in D.C. in our nation's capital with a home team, the Redskins, on top. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Redskins have an edge in time of possession right now. The Vikings, though, are still right in this game and will certainly be looking for a way to pull this one out in the second.
Ed, hello and welcome to your halftime stat show. This is Randy Replay. Good to see you again back here in Minneapolis. We're going to go over some stats Total yards of offense, Minnesota's leading 261 to 207. Rushing yards, it's been very, very difficult for both teams to rush the ball. Minnesota sitting at 37, split between all four running backs. Washington, 45. Passing yards, it goes to Minnesota with 224. First downs in the first half, it is 13 to 8. Punt return yards, 40, of course. Kick return yards, 76. That goes to us. Total yards, 377 to 276. Turnovers. We did commit one. Kenny Erickson threw an interception. Wasn't his fault. They got batted at the line, popped up. I don't consider it an interception, but NFL does. There was a legit turnover. Zachary Anderson picked off Kirk Cousins in that first quarter. Third down conversions. We are 4 for 8, that is 50%. Red zone, 3 for 3, one touchdown but two field goals. You want to see all three be touchdowns, obviously. The Washington is 2 for 2 as well. Red zone field goals, we got two, I explained that. Four penalties, all coming within the red zone for the Washington football team. Counting them, 30 yards. Time of possession, 11-22, favor of Minnesota. We're going to take a look at the Viking stats. Kenny Erickson with a rating of 91.3. He is 20 for 29. That is 68% completion percentage for those of you that don't know how to do math or didn't look over here. He has 241 yards, the one touchdown to Josh Gable, and the interception. Rushing, I lied. There is three running backs active so far in this game. We have not seen Travis Parker. Danny Hendricks, 5 for 13. He leads the team in carries. Sam Gable leads the team in yards, 4 for 17 yards. Matthew Peterson, the fullback, not really at a running back. They put him in there, though. 3 for 7. So to have everybody in this rotation only come away with 30 yards or so, minus the fullback, it's not looking good. We got to get the ball rolling. Only 9 carries in the first half by running backs. Receiving, Luke Slezuski, 4 for 42. Cameron Quick had a big first half. He's 3 for 71. Travis Parker, 3 for 26. Luis Gonzalez, 3 for 41. Josh Gable, 2 for 16. He did have the touchdown. Lou Wang, 2 for 11. Wesley Holm, 1 for 9. Blake Letellier had a big third down catch. 1 for 22. Darian Wilson, 1 for 3. Nobody cares about blocking. We're going to take a look at total tackles. Zachary Anderson has 7. He also does have an INT interception. Chi Buckwa with 6. Jacob Pickering with 5. Kevin Stark, Scott Rethwill, Otis McMiller, Thaddeus Rosu, Robert Nichols, Aaron Nelson, and George Thornton each have 3. Danny Pickering, Justin Vandershoff, Dan Nolte each have 2. Sean Clausen, Tevin Fair, Paul Fritchie, Richard Salthy, apparently Matthew Peterson, and Luis Gonzalez has 1.
Fix your stuff, EA.
Tackles for loss. We have Tevin Fair, Thaddeus Rosu, Robert Nichols, and Kevin Stark, each with a tackle for loss in the game. Sacks, Otis McMiller, and then Scott Rethwill and Kevin Stark have a half each. Interceptions, the Lone Rangers. Zachary Anderson, all the way from Wyoming. He has the lone. There are no forced fumbles, no fumble recoveries, no safeties, and no field goal or punt blocks. Kicking, we had a couple big kicks here. He is 2 for 2, longest of 25, to give us the 13 points. Punting, there are 2 for 100 yards each, landing within the 20. He is averaging 97 net punt yards. So we're allowing only three punt return yards. And kick returns, Luke Slezuski took 1 for 34. Darian Wilson, 2 for 42. We're going to get you back out. Oh, punt returns. Sorry, 2 for 40 for Robert Nichols. We're going to get you back out to the game you are currently watching, which is the Minnesota Vikings at the Washington football team. I'm going to get you back out there. As you can see, right here in this pictograph. Two touchdowns for Kirk Cousins. He has 73% completion percentage. We cannot let that stand in the second half. We're going to get destroyed. He only has 179 yards, though. I think that is the least amount of throwing yards we have allowed in the first half of a game. So we got that going for us. No injuries to report in the first half. I think that's also the first time that's ever happened this year. So Randy Replay is signing off with some stank on it. We're going to get you back down to the field.
And ready to go for the third quarter. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line.
Now he can run anything and catch the ball as we just saw there.
And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. He needed a yard, that's what he got. On play action, Cousins. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. It'll go as a loss.
Fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone.
Under pressure, they got him again. And now that brings up fourth down there, a loss of 6 yards on the sack. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback because he had no chance to block him. And stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front.
He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver with his first career NFL touchdown.
I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a good...
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Pierre Garçon.
Nowadays.
Play fake to Jones. Now Cousins. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. Offensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. And now that brings up fourth down there. A loss of 6 yards on the sack.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
Now let's go! 3-19!
They'll look to throw here. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he's brought down after a good game. 23 yards.
All right, here we go.
Looking to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Ryan Kerrigan, he's the one to get it.
Someone did not get blocked. He's the one who got home.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be marked down deep in Washington territory. An unbelievable play there on fourth and long. Score here in the late going. They're going to look to throw. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Positive to carry forward from that last drive.
Well, a few different things that you carry forward. Number one, as you noted, they were...
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second. And quickly, they get to the line. He'll look to throw. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Pierre Garçon, the intended, since being hurried, he got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. They'll run it now out of the gun. Just a yard on the run.
A little bit too quickly.
He's back to throw. It's brought in by Jackson.
A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. Well, Charles, they were close in the end, but they couldn't get that last play, that last little miracle play done. They were within striking distance, but couldn't find a way to score.
They definitely had hope. They definitely had opportunity, just unable to cash in at the end. Not an easy play by any stretch, but they definitely had a chance.
And there you have it. The Minnesota Vikings hold on to beat the Washington Football Club. Wow. What a nail biter. Watching the game back here in Minneapolis, I was a little worried they got that last play. If there was 10 seconds left on the clock when they hit that last play instead of six, I think, given the way the defense played on that last drive, the drive before last, when we got the turnover or the knockdown, I think they would have scored on the last drive. I really do. That, or the last play there, if they had 10 seconds. The last drive, they were moving down the field pretty much at will. Stopped them. They got a big third down. That's how this defense is made up. But we hold on to get the victory. Minnesota Vikings 30, Washington 24. Big exhale. Let's get into these stats. Kenny Erickson filling in for the injured Smeagol Axberg. His quarterback rating at the half was just under 100. 91, I believe. He ended with 113.4. Now, the run game, as you'll see, did not do anything in this game. So he was 32. He had to throw the ball 45 times. That is 71% completion percentage, for those of you that don't know how to do math or did look over here. 423 yards. In the first half, he had one touchdown and one interception. Since then, he went 2 for 0. Three touchdowns, one interception to end the game. Average yards per attempt, just under 9.5. His longest pass was 47 to Luke Slezewski for the touchdown. Rushing, we went up against the number one rushing defense in the league, so these numbers don't surprise me. This number does, though. Zero touchdowns. That is the first time your Minnesota Vikings don't have a rushing touchdown in a game this year. Sam Gabriel, 8 for 27. He led the team in carries and in yards. Matthew Peterson, who they just threw him in here for this game, kind of see how it went. It went pretty good. 7 for 16. Daniel Henrich, 7 for 24. That puts him in second. So ever since coming back from injury, Daniel Henrich has been playing outstanding. Travis Parker in this one, 3 carries in the second half for negative 3 yards. Just having a bad season, or a bad game, sorry. He's having a good season. This was a bad game for the whole team. So, Aaron Moss, 2 for 4. Kenny Erickson, 1 for 3 on that second down in the second half to get him into a little bit. I think they punted on that, but anyway. Yeah. Yak Yard, Sam Gabriel, and Denny Hendricks both have 10. Longest run of the day will go to Sam Gabriel with 7 yards for the longest run of the day. That is atrocious. But against the number one rated defense for rushing, that is okay, I suppose. They really shut us down. We had to go to the ball, or go to the air, through the air with the ball a lot. Randy Replay can't talk today, ladies and gentlemen. Receiving, Luke Slezewski still leads the team. Well, he's tied. 5 catches for 70 yards. He got his first touchdown of the season today. You got to remember, he was out for the first 5 games. So, I mean, 8 yards. It is what it is. Luis Gonzalez, 5 catches, 94 yards, no touchdowns. Travis Parker, though, came up big in the fourth quarter. 4 catches through the game, 31 yards, and a touchdown. Wesley Holm, 3 for 29. Lou Wang, 3 for 16. Cameron Quick, 3 for 71. Josh Gable, 2 for 16. He also had a touchdown. Travis Lee getting involved today, 2 for 18. Blake Letellier, 2 for 32. He had the big fourth down or third down conversion in the first half. And it was Luis Gonzalez who had the big fourth down conversion to get them in to that range where they could get a field goal to go up by a touchdown. Darian Wilson, 2 for 23. He was just double covered on most of the plays. You'll see in the replay. Anthony Bisbee had the one catch on the third down for 23 yards. Nobody cares about blocking, so we're going to go straight to defense. And look at total tackles. 11 tackles for Jacob Pickering, Zachy Ree Anderson, and Chi Mukwa. Just insane. Robert Nichols had 7. Justin Vandershaft with 6. Tevin Fair, Aaron Nelson, George Thornton, Scott Rethville, Thaddeus Rosie with 5. Kevin Stark, Otis McMillan with 4, Richard Salthy with 3, Josh Fitzer, Danny Pickering, Dan Nolte with 2, Ryan Bielo, Jeremy Lindsay, Sean Clausen, Paul Fritchie with 1. Fix your crap, EA. Tackles for loss. There was 2 by Scott Rethwell, 2 by Kevin Stark, Tevin Fair, Jacob Pickering, Thaddeus Rosie, Robert Nichols each with 1. Ha! Sacks. We're going to take a look at this sack. Most of these sacks came in the fourth quarter up here at the top of the screen. Tevin Fair with 1.5. Jeremy Lindsay with 1. Richard Salthy with 1. George Thornton with 1. Otis McMillan with 1. Josh Fitzer, Scott Rethwell, and Kevin Stark will each split some of these up here with 0.5 sack. Whew. Interceptions, the Lone Ranger, Zachary Anderson. Kicking, Brandon Baker sealed the deal. 3 for 300%. Longest field goal was 34. That was to put them in the lead late. 3 for 3 on extra points. Punting, Taylor Pelin, 4 punts, 197 yards. You really got to put your faith in the defense. 3 of those landed within the 20. 1, it was skeptical. It could have went in, it could have went out. But it's neither here nor there. We got the win. Luke Slezewski, 1 kick return for 34 yards. Darren Wilson, 3 for 72. Robert Nichols, not Richard, 2 for 40 on punt returns. And that is that. So you're 4-5, Minnesota Vikings. We're getting back up to 500. 1 game down from 500. They take the victory here today, 30-24. This is Randy Replay signing off. We thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next one. See you!